Hello and good evening, and thank you so much for joining us today. We will give it a few minutes for others to join, though we have mailed the link, but I guess it takes time because this is a new way of connecting for many of us. Therefore, I'm just giving it a few minutes. In the meanwhile, may I please request each one who is here to please introduce yourself in the chat window. And also to mention your school. So please write your school name and your name in the chat window. Thank you so much for that. Also, during this webinar, till we are conducting the webinar, we'll request everyone to kindly stay on mute and use only audio to join in so that the voice is clear for all. We'll pause at many places in between so that we are able to accommodate your comments and see how you're doing. So we will be pausing at many places out there. I believe it's raining across the country and it's raining in someone's microphone. Once again, I request you to kindly stay on mute. Thank you so much. Hello and good evening to everyone who's joining in. You're most welcome to join in at any time and leave any time that you feel like. And we are just going to begin this session in less than a minute. We just wanted to give it 5 minutes for people to join in. In the meanwhile, while you're here, we request you to please type your name and your school name in the chat window, please. Hi Jigyasa, request you to please type your name and your school name in the chat window, please. Hi Ragini. Hi Vandita. Hi Mudisar. Great. So as people keep joining in, I don't want to waste time for people who have already joined in. So without further ado, let's begin. We are here to talk about Microsoft Certified Innovative Educators, how to become certified MIEs. And I'm getting some messages where people say that you cannot hear anything. If that is the case, please let me know. Can you now hear me? If you can hear me, give me a thumbs up, please. If you can hear me, just say yes or give me a thumbs up in the chat window, please. Looks like you can't hear me. Hold on. Let me check. All right. Now can you hear me? Awesome. Good evening and thank you so much for joining in. My mistake completely. I was actually talking to myself, I guess. But a very, very warm welcome to today's session. I am just going to begin this session. But before we begin the session, I'm going to request you to kindly type your name and your school name in the chat window. I do have my chat window running and I do see many hellos and hi's out there. So hello to everyone who is here, and I'm sure many more will join in. I'm going to share my screen as I'm going to present to you. But I have a humble request to please keep yourself on mute. I don't know why everything is echoing. Yeah. Okay, is it better now? Yes, definitely. Thank you. Kindly stay on mute. We will be giving you many opportunities where we will ask you to unmute yourself and speak to us. So yes, as you keep joining, please do say a hello. Do mention your name and your school name in the chat window. So without further ado, we are here to talk about the Microsoft in education, what programs Microsoft has to offer. And before I do that, I am very, very thankful, excited, and very, very enthusiastic because Sunbeam School has joined in almost full strength, I would say. And I'm very happy to say that we had more than 85 registrations today for this session. And of those, almost. Kindly mute yourself. There's a lot of disturbance. Can you please mute yourself? Thank you. I think, Richa, there's a lot of noise from your end. Richa, could you please mute yourself? Thank you. Richa, request you to please mute yourself. Duhita, can you please reach out to Richa? Thank you. Archana, may I please request you to mute yourself? Great. Archana, can you please mute yourself? Archana, there's a mic icon if you can mute yourself. Awesome. So great. I think we have cancelled most of the noise. I still hear Richa. I hear noise. Can I please request you to mute? I'm going to share my screen again so that you're able to see what we are going to talk about. Awesome. Once again, kindly mute yourself. I'm going to introduce the webinar host now. I'm Meenakshi Oberoi, and I'm the education evangelist and founding director of D-Pedagogics. With me today is Duhita Parmar, who is our education technology consultant. And Duhita, can you please say a hello to everybody? Thank you everyone for joining in. We had an overwhelming response to our webinar today. We will keep requesting you through chat and through talk to kindly mute yourself. You will have many opportunities to unmute yourself. And Duhita will mostly be looking at the chat window and helping me out with this webinar today. And Duhita, may I request you to please reach out to people to say that, you know, if they could mute yourself. Thank you. I'm sorry, there's a lot of noise, so I'm just waiting for everyone to mute themselves. Awesome. We have some silence again, and I'm absolutely sorry for all of this, what's happening. But next time, I guess this will also go as an instruction. I would like to introduce ourselves here for a minute. Deep Pedagogics is a learning partner with Microsoft, and we bring to you all school programs, all K-12 and higher ed programs. This is one of the programs from Microsoft, which is a certification program to become a Microsoft Innovative Educator. We always begin with a thought, and here's today's thought. If we teach today's students as we taught yesterday's, we rob them of tomorrow. Said by John Dewey, and I completely am with him. And I'm sure those who have joined today are not here to rob their students of tomorrow. Why Microsoft and what are we doing? Well, our whole idea is to make learning available anytime, everywhere, anywhere, and to everyone possible. We want engagement to be accelerated in the classrooms. We want engaged learners. We want engaging learning environments. We want engaged educators. And of course, we are here to share engaging practices with you. But what's new? Well, the last that you would have heard of Microsoft, if you haven't been in touch, it would be about Word and Windows and PowerPoint and Excel. Well, today, Microsoft Education stands for much more than that. It stands for, I'm just going to take a pause here. Sorry, but I'm just going to move out of this room. I really need to check who this is. Ma'am, can you be on mute, please? Richa, ma'am, can you please be on mute? Also, your video is on, ma'am. Thank you. Preeti is quiet now. Richa, you're mute. Yeah, you need to mute yourself. There will be a mic button like this. Can you please mute yourself like this? Simply click on it once. Duhita, can you connect with Richa one-on-one, please? Can you call her up and explain, kindly explain, please? Thank you. Okay. Kriti? Preeti, you need to be on mute, please. Thank you. All right, this is much better. Thank you so much. And I apologize that I've asked you to stay on mute. Okay, so we were talking about what's new with Microsoft. Here's what's new with Microsoft. Microsoft has come with Windows 10. Preeti, this is your mic. Preeti, could you please mute yourself? There will be a mic button on your screen if you could mute yourself. I think you're on mute. Thank you so very much. So what's new are the new devices, which are more affordable. When we look at our labs, when we look at the computer labs in our schools, we normally have desktops, which have actually been there since our school would have opened up. It's actually time for us to renew our labs, make them mobile labs, and new devices are available.
even from a company like HP, a Hewlett Packard device is available at about INR 41,000, so which is hardly a price to pay. That comes along with Windows 10. Along with that, we have something new called Microsoft Teams. If you want to stay together just the way we are right now and do much more, do all your collaborative work through one platform, it is Microsoft Teams. Windows keeps sending out their own updates, and you need to be updated, and it's very difficult for you to afford those updates all the time. Therefore, we have a special program called MASP, Microsoft Aspire School Program, for that. There's Intune for Education, which is completely simple. Sounds very high, but it's a simple setup and it's an easy control to sync your school data. The most difficult part is that we have to run and we have to overpressurize the IT department in every school to actually look and take control of syncing the entire data, and it takes them time. So here's an app which you can manage even from your phone. It's called Intune for Education. There's something very exciting that's happening in the world of gaming right now. Minecraft has had a tie-up with Microsoft, and we have Minecraft Education Edition with code builder abilities available at a very nominal price on annual renewal basis. And all of this, if wasn't enough, here's something that's called something which I would call a magic tool. Well, these are learning tools. These are free of cost and they are available in OneNote, Word, Microsoft Edge, and Outlook. What they are and what all these things can do for you, let's just move forward to understand. Before I move on, I must tell you that this presentation today will be available to you. We will be mailing this to you in a PDF format. Therefore, do not worry about the data. It'll come to you. What matters in your classroom is today, every teacher who is joined today has this on top of their mind. They want their students to be ready with 21st century skills. You're looking for job readiness. When you are, your students enter colleges and then jobs, they definitely will need skills of using Microsoft tools. Because more than 80% of the corporates in the world use Microsoft technology, especially Office 365. You need equity and empowerment in your classrooms, and definitely you need personalized learning. Well, if you're looking for all of this, here's what we're going to present to you. We're going to present to you collaborative learning spaces. With Microsoft, what you can do is you can create multiple learning spaces for powerful collaboration between classes and schools. This is just not jargon that I'm talking about. We're going to give you real life examples of how to bring this into your class. Feedback is something that we've always talked about as teachers. I wish I could just give a feedback right now to my students. So here's a platform where you can provide immediate feedback as your students are working in real time. You can co-create with them. You can collaborate using Office while creating a PowerPoint presentation for an upcoming presentation that you have to make in your school or anywhere else. You first start making a presentation, then you mail it to your colleague and the colleague adds. You don't need to wait for all of that. You can actually work collaboratively, seamlessly, and quickly and very efficiently assign and track documents. When you send out a homework, you get to hear from students that they lost it, it got wet in the rain, and so many more reasons. But here's something that when you assign your homework to your students, you can actually track who's read, who's responded, how much has he responded, how much time did this student take to respond to the questionnaire or the worksheet that I've sent. Do you know that the forms that you have filled to register for this call, we had the whole data as you collected in real time collected with us in an Excel sheet. That is how we were so efficiently being able to send you mails back telling you what to do and how to connect today. I'm sorry, I'm a little under the weather. I'm coughing, so I'm muting myself at many points. Before I move forward, I want to do a bit of hygiene here. I want to check if you can hear me or if you have any questions so far. I'll appreciate if you can type your question in the chat window and leave it there. Duhita will catch the question and bring it to us so that we are able to answer that question for you. I'm pausing for less than a minute just to catch your questions and catch my breath. So please go ahead and ask questions. Hi, Sunil. I read your... And yes, very important. Please do introduce yourself by writing your name and your school name. Thank you for joining, and please do keep sending in your highs and hellos with your name and your school name. Again, a very warm welcome, and without further ado, let me move forward. We're here to help educators and students. Windows has a dedicated team that keeps working towards making your experience a better experience in education. We understand that you do not have time to stop, pause, and make adjustments. Therefore, we have a whole team of developers who sit down to do this for you. Some of the features of... Sorry. Some of the features of this very interface of Windows 10 have been mentioned here, and they will come to you. But without getting into further details, I shall move forward. One HP device that is doing extremely well with schools is HP ProBook. Please do take cognition of this if you're looking for devices. Feel free to connect with us. Every slide will give you ways of how to connect with us. You have our email ID. I've also given you phone number of Tanu directly, who manages all of this for us. So please do take a look at that. This is a beautiful program from Microsoft. It actually makes things so affordable for us. I know if there are IT managers and IT administrators in this forum, or if you go back and take this whole proposition to them, the first thing that will come to their mind will be the costing. Well, I'll pause here to explain to you that MASP, that is Microsoft School Aspire program, is a specially designed program for K-12 schools, that is from nursery to 12. And the pricing has been done at an 80% discounted rate than the commercial pricing of Office 365 and Windows 10 and Intune. What you get as a part of this package is Office 365 Pro Plus, Windows 10 upgrade, and these upgrades will be valid for the entire year of your subscription, and Intune. These three are the fixed components of what you get. And then there's a fourth component which you can choose from, which is Imagine Academy. That's an annual subscription, or four eyeball tablets, or an e-fee software for fee payment, or a very effective reporting software, which is Report B. We will be pushing in links to all of these to you so that we don't take up your time here to talk about all of this. And then, of course, there's the best option possible. That's the Minecraft Education Edition that's available to you. The pricing that is written here is an approximate pricing, which varies a little bit here and there every month. But the current pricing for August is at INR 5500 per user for a minimum of 25 users. And how you can get this, or how you can get more information about this, is by writing to us. You have our email IDs, and also you have our phone number of Tanu. And you can directly reach out to Tanu Gupta. She's going to be one of your mentors. And also, please feel free to connect with me anytime. You have my number in your mail. So just ping me, mail me, whichever way, and we are happy to talk further about this. This is a license. This license is a user-based license, and users are calculated only as for educators. That is the total FTE count, faculty, full-time faculty count. And there's a formula for that, which we'll give to you as you need it. And the students will go free, which means if you are buying 25 licenses for educators, 1,000 students, up to 1,000 students get go free of cost. So their licensing is not charged. They're charged at rupee one so that we are able to make an account for them. Otherwise, they are not charged and the student accounts go free. Enough of commercials and let's get to what we do best. Let's look at all the modern tools which help us collaborate, which I've been talking about till now. If you go to your Microsoft Store, a Windows 10 store will give you so many apps that you can do such amazing work with. Some of my favorite being Kahoot, which is a hot favorite of all our teachers. They use it as a quizzing app. Then you, of course, have your Minecraft Education Edition, for which when you download Minecraft Education Edition from our stores, may I please request you to mute yourself? So when you download Minecraft Education Edition from the store, you get 10 chances to use it free of cost, post which you have to buy, and you may please feel free to reach out to us and we'll help you understand how to buy that. So there are some amazing apps waiting for you to explore. The one favorite app I think teachers across the globe will swear by is Skype. Well, it's not only this Skype, it's Skype in the classroom. You can actually bring a world into your classroom. This is of most interest to our teachers and we get queries about how can we join Skype. Well, you need to join our educator community. You will find virtual field trips which are pre-designed for you. There will be guest speakers available. You can play mystery Skype and you can even join collaborative projects. More on this when we reach the site. Oh yes, there's so much that you can do with this. And of course, there's Minecraft Education Edition. Minecraft, please look at it like a game of Lego. Whatever you can do with Lego, you can do it in Minecraft and you can do much more in Minecraft because this is a 3D blocks game which helps you create. What you see here in this image is the structure of the eye. This can be rotated in all the 360 degree, and you can study the entire structure of eye using Minecraft. There's so much more about Minecraft that you can do. Please connect with us. Minecraft is different than your Minecraft Education Edition. Minecraft Education Edition has a tie-up with Microsoft to bring you this at a very nominal price of about INR 450 per user. Again, this is an annual renewal. So, let's lighten it up. Old crow needs to become a modern crow. So you need to update yourself. We need to update ourselves constantly. We call ourselves lifelong learners because we are here to learn and teach together. If that's your intent, here's your address to go to. By now, you should have received an email from us which would have prompted you to have an Outlook account. So I'm assuming you've already created a Microsoft account or you already have an Outlook or a Hotmail account. If you have that, this is the ID where you need to go. This is the address where you need to go. You need to go to education.microsoft.com. This is the kind of screen that you will get and you can click on Join Now to join this. What you will find over there is if this will enable peer support and feedback because there are thousands and thousands of educators out there who are ready to help you. There are new ideas out there. Your idea is one which is the best. Therefore, please contribute your ideas there. I've always been a believer and I always tell everyone, please do not only be a consumer of these platforms, be a contributor. Don't just go and look for lesson plans. Don't just go and look for new ideas, innovative practices. Please go contribute. Your practices are always the best because you're the ones who are working with students and you know how to work the best. There is loads that rest here. You can do so much on this website. All you need to do is you need to go to education.microsoft.com and log in. I'm going to run you through the steps. If you do not have an Outlook account, please go to outlook.com and create one. When it prompts you to sign in, do not try and sign in using any of the accounts that are outside of Microsoft accounts, that is your Yahoo or your Gmail account or any of those accounts, kindly click on create one, and it'll automatically take you to create account, where it'll have this suffix of @outlook.com already available. There are other suffix that are available. You may simply write, let's say it's Meenakshi, so Meenakshi Oberoi or Meenakshi.Oberoi or Meenakshi Oberoi@outlook.com is already there. So you create your account there first. Then in the next tab, please type education.microsoft.com and click on join now. I'm going to pause here because I see questions in our chat window and they are of utmost importance to us. I'm going to pause and I'm going to request Duhita to please tell me what the questions are. Sure. Thank you, Duhita, for that. The benefits of being MI expert are manifold. First of all, I started my journey as MI expert in about, I think about 2015. So I've been an MI expert for the last more than 3 years and also have been MI fellow for the last 2 years. May I please request you to mute yourself, Richa? Thank you. So there are many, the way I have transformed my learning is totally, I would say, if not 360 degree, definitely a 180 degree turn. You get many opportunities to learn from each other, from a world global community. You get to join so many projects. You also get an exclusive opportunity to showcase your work that you are doing in your classrooms to educators, not only within India, but outside of India. If your projects have a call, which is a global quality, Microsoft takes cognition of that and you are taken to global platforms to showcase your work. I have been to a regional event in Korea way back in 2005, where I showcased my project and learned from others. And when I went for these opportunities, there were so many sessions that were going on, which were an eye-opener for me. And believe you me, some of those things I'm still learning. Imagine this has been more than a decade and a half, and I still call myself a learner. There is so much of innovation and so many good practices that keep coming your way. A small example is what I'm going to quote here. These are literally life-changing experiences when you attend these forums. One of my plans, which was a very simple plan about photosynthesis, which I had created in 2005, and I won a Microsoft Innovative Educator Award at that time. I'd gone to Korea, and I thought what I was taking was something simply beautiful because there were only 5 educators from India who were flown to Seoul for that. But today, when I look back, I think it was a minuscule of what I knew. I have turned around my learning. Today, I can not only present a stimulating presentation to my students, I can create an experience using OneNote and Microsoft Teams, Forms and Sway put together. I can create a platform which is available to students for anytime learning. So I not only present using, I not only plan using OneNote, I present to my class using OneNote, my students work in that notebook, and my entire portfolio of that lesson plan is available in that very notebook. I will digress a little bit and take you to my notebook to show you how one can plan, if I can fetch very quickly, because we are very open to digressing from what we are doing and actually taking you to show what you've just asked for. So let me show you one of these lesson plans. This is a lesson plan on friendly farming. This is a class notebook. So I have a collaboration space with my students. I have content library and I have my students along with. These are the different pages. This is what a OneNote notebook looks like. And I have my entire lesson plan here. When I have to talk to my students, I can directly distribute pages from here, giving them handouts, class notes, homework, and quizzes. So if you see, I have everything packed in one place. I don't have to roam around places to show them. And everything that I need to present is all collated in one place. I guess someone has again switched on the mic. Yeah, Anupama ma'am, may I request you to kindly mute? Actually, the echoing starts if I give you the opportunity to unmute. So this is how I've just given you a very short glimpse how within my OneNote notebook, I have my presentation embedded, I have my forms embedded, and I have all the links embedded here. So my students don't have to go to internet to search. They can search and work within this notebook. My entire portfolio of my lesson plan is available here. I hope I've been able to give you a glimpse of it. More on this, you can find on our educator network. Once again, if you go to education.microsoft.com and go to courses and resources, there are courses available on each of these tools. There are about 198 courses that are available. But let me not scare you by telling that. All these courses have been very nicely planned and divided. Let me take you to this site to show you that each of these courses have been minutely, very carefully planned, and they are self-paced. You don't need to sit in one go and complete the entire course. You can simply start a course on a subject that interests you. Let's say I'm getting into teaching with technology basics. Now, this is a learning path where we have so many courses embedded inside. So there are 13 courses available here. You will earn about 1500 points. You will earn an authentic Microsoft certificate, which is valid in across the globe in any job, in any form possible. And of course, you earn a badge for this. If I scroll you through this, this has been divided into smaller duration courses, which are of about 20 minutes. And doing each of these courses, you earn points, you earn a badge, and many of them are actually authentic Microsoft certificates that you earn. If you notice, some of these mention that they are required and some of them are optional. So you may skip a few to actually complete your course, but we would highly recommend you to go through each of these courses and then become a teacher which is loaded with not only ideas but how to use these ICT tools in your classrooms without changing your lesson plans, how to bring in technology into your classrooms without really giving each child a device, how you can better your lesson plans, increase your productivity, bring in collaboration within your classroom and support your students' learning. I hope I've been able to give you a glimpse of what I'm talking about. Once again, I'm going to pause and ask Duhita if there are more questions available right now. Thank you, Duhita. As for the Skype session, Duhita, can you mute yourself, please? Thank you. I'm so sorry. I might sound very rude, but I have to ask you to mute yourself for benefit of all. So kindly bear with me. For Skype, I'll just talk about Skype, Shimi. Just give me a minute. For those who want to ask questions about anything to do with technicality of how to make this operational, please feel free to reach out right after this call to any of us via mail, via phone, via message, any which way that you are comfortable, and we'll be happy to tell you. Or you may stay back in this call post everybody's queries are done. I'm more than happy to connect with you one-on-one. Getting back to what Shimi has asked, let me take you back to the site to show you. Shimi, on education.microsoft.com, there is Skype in the classroom. When you click on this icon on the left, it's a blue icon. You get a drop-down menu which takes you through various options available on Skype in the classroom. it's a huge community that's available out here. You can simply click on any of these options between virtual field trips, Skype lessons, Skype collaborations, mystery Skype or guest speaker to get into these details. I will just get into that. But let me quickly show you what's quickly available to you. Here's what's available. You have a whole notebook because what a teacher needs is a lesson plan. Without a lesson plan, I am actually nothing. So there is a whole lesson plan which is available free of cost. There is no cost of involved anywhere in this interface that I'm talking to you about. So you can simply download this notebook and start your journey, start your Skype lesson. If you're still hesitant, we are happy to do the first Skype lesson with you. Please book your Skype sessions. I'll just show you how to book using this website. You can learn all about animals. You can get into teaching students empathy and kindness. You can explore more resources and you can calendar the events. Every month, Skype comes up with a new focus, with a new theme. You can join that theme. You can have your Skype in the classroom activity plan out here. You can explore what other people are doing and upgrade, of course, anytime that you feel like. There are educator voices that are available here. You can hear from others. You can meet others. This Skype lessons has lesson plans available for you to take away. Let me take you to one of the icons. I will not be able to accommodate going to all the places here, but let me quickly go to my favorite, which is the virtual field trip. Imagine without leaving your classroom, you can take a live virtual field trip with the experts, museums, parks. You can take them anywhere that you want. I'm very conscious of the time and I completely understand if you have to leave and go, but please, let's make one thing very clear that we have established that you will have to create an Outlook or a Microsoft account. Then click on Join Now, this icon on the right, and join this platform. It's a free of cost platform, and then begin your journey here. You can search these Skype lessons according to subject, age group, location, whatever you want. The filters are available here. So these are the filters. You can go by region, language, and yes, languages are available. Live translator is available within Skype. So you can actually Skype with people in any language. Post our questions. I might build up time for Duhita to share her experience of connecting with a classroom in Hong Kong. But before that, I'm going to show you how to become your Microsoft Innovative Educator. When you click on this green icon on the left, it shows become a Microsoft Innovative Educator. It's super simple. You can start your journey by simply earning 1,000 points by doing any of the courses mentioned here. To simplify your life, what we have done is in the presentation that we are sharing with you today, we have packed in exact courses that you can do to earn a MIE certification. These are two of the courses that we recommend. Tweet Meet. If you're not on Twitter, please join Twitter today. It's one of our most favorite tools for learning, for professional learning. So please join Twitter and you can do this course on Tweet Meet to understand how. Hour of Code is conducted every November. So you can go to code.org and can host Hour of Code in your school free of cost. Again, do this course to understand how. The deadline for you to earn your MIE Kindly mute yourself, please. So deadline, wow, I get to hear a jingle. May I request you to please mute yourself? Yeah, there's a small baby singing. Thank you so much. So the deadline is 10th September. Please do your course. Your deadline is 10th September. Please do your course. Earn this badge. Take a screenshot the way I've taken. And we'll help you amplify your profile. We'll help you establish yourself in the educator community. And please submit it here. We have given your links. These are your mentors, Duhita Parmar, Bandita Nath, and Tanu Gupta. There are three mentors that you have along with me. These are their email IDs. Please reach out to them. I will request you to please earn your MIE badge and submit. Go to this link, bit.ly link, and submit it. This link is different than the one that you used for registration. Please use this link to register. Guess what? For attending today's session also, you get to earn points. Please use this promo code. When you click on this education.microsoft.com/main/promo code, you can go there to redeem these and you will earn points for attending today's session too. So please become a certified MIE. If you are still unclear, we will be back on 25th of August and 29th of August and 1st of September to meet you for the same reason. Excite more educators within your school, bring them to this platform, help them become Microsoft Innovative Educator, because that helps you too. More on that, I'm available here. This is how you can reach us. As promised, we will be sharing this presentation with you via your email, and we will be posting it here too. So please stay available. Thank you, Duhita. She's constantly posting these links and these promo codes in the chat window. This is where the chat window is. Please access it. I'm going to mute myself to ask Duhita if there are more questions. Thank you, Duhita. I'm going to answer this question by telling you it's no different. This is your Microsoft journey. You know, since we started learning about computers, we have been using Microsoft tools. We know how to use Word. We know how to use PowerPoint. We know how to use Excel. We want to take our journey to the next level and our students to be ready for jobs tomorrow. We need to make these tools available to them. Anupma ma'am, I know you want to say something, so I'm going to mute myself. Please go ahead and say it. Yes. Yes, I can hear you. Please go ahead. Good evening and Jai Hind to you. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you so much for your question. May I please kindly request you to mute yourself so that I can answer? Thank you. Thank you so much. Very valid question. How is it going to help my students? Right now, what we are doing is we are using technology as teachers. We have not been able to involve our students fully in this immersive platform. We need to teach our students how to use these tools. They should be able to use tools which they will need tomorrow in their jobs. Also, they need accessibility. What happens is, ma'am, we make a PowerPoint, we show them that PowerPoint or the resources that we have, let's say from Pearson or any of those platforms in our classrooms, and beyond which the availability to the student is very limited. But this is a platform where in an offline mode also you can make it available to your students. You can live record your voice. You need not play the voice of a Pearson person. You may understand it as a teacher and then do a voiceover and record your voice to present it and save it in OneNote notebook. This OneNote notebook can be shared with students just before the exams. So students want to hear your voice, what you taught in the class, because you and me know half the times they are not listening for those entire 40 minutes. But they want to hear what you said just exactly once again. This is their opportunity that these... You don't need to upload these videos or, you know, you don't need to make this data available to them somewhere. This is automatically available to them through Office 365. And they can access it, view it, and learn from you even when they are not sitting with you. When questions arise in my classroom, I'm not able to answer all the questions. And half the times we tell them, you know, I'm going to answer this later. And sometimes that later doesn't come and it's very frustrating for a child.
So these questions, these transactions, these conversations can be carried on using Microsoft Teams, using Skype. These are safe platforms for usage because these are not accessible without a link. So you can make this link available to your student. You can set an expiry date to this link. You can send out these links only to the ones that you want the students to join. So the usability is vast. This is a very short duration for me to explain the entire usability. But I'm more than happy to reach out to your school. We are more than happy to come to your school to explain. Please send us an email to say that you would be interested to hear more about this. We'll be happy to come to your school to show you more and beyond what we have talked today. I hope I've been able to help you understand and give you a glimpse, little bit of a glimpse of what I'm trying to say, but definitely I'm happy to take more questions. Thank you, Dohita. That's a very valid question again. Takeaway is that we want our students to, we want our teachers to deliver quality when they are talking, when they are, you know, when they are presenting to their students. We do not want our students to think that we are redundant and that we do not know how to use technology because our students are using technology in a better manner than us. We want our teachers updated. And Microsoft has opened up this world for teachers. Many, I think about 4 to 5 years ago, we started this journey and we started opening. Right now, we want to make this available to every teacher in every corner of the world. And therefore, we are making ourselves available through these webinars that please reach out to us. We are happy to help you. We are happy to train you. We are happy to tell you what are the benefits of joining this program and why you should take this learning to your classroom. So this is a forum to take back not only our voice into your classrooms, but authentic Microsoft certifications for your teachers, which I think over years we've been hearing, we need quality education to be delivered in our classrooms. Well, here's an opportunity to deliver quality education in your classrooms. The lesson plans that are available on our network are Microsoft approved lesson plans. You will see certain quality in them. So when our teachers submit their lesson plans, they are actually viewed and reviewed by a panel before they can be made live on these platforms. I hope I've covered all. Dohita, feel free to add more if you would like to. Shivi, thank you. I know you've been around for quite some time. We've been pressed for time a little bit because, like I said, the way our community is growing, it is an amazing pace. When we announced this webinar also, we got an overwhelming response. So from only scheduling it on 1st September, we scheduled and we divided our audience into many dates. We gave them an option to join. Yes, Tuesday. Those were Tech Talk Tuesdays. We hosted 30-minute webinars every Tuesday. Those are still available to you. The recordings are available to you on YouTube. So please go to YouTube, look up our channel, which goes by the name Deep Pedagogics, and you will be able to access. And Shimi, it's a promise that we will try our level best to come back with it as early as possible. And to answer Anupama ma'am's questions, like I said, I'm happy to even make someone travel tomorrow to come to speak to you. We are that available to you. So definitely, please, we are just a mail or a phone call away. Just send us a mail or a phone call and we'll make those arrangements for someone to come to you. Varanasi is definitely not far away. Would love to visit. I've been to your school last year. I did a workshop via Pearson. So yes, I have a relationship and a very good relationship with Mrs. Berman. I would love to come back to you. Dohita, more questions, please. Sure, go ahead, please. All right. Great. Great. So I wouldn't call these questions technical. So I'm just straight away going to answer these questions. What I understand is you want to know about more tools. There was a slide where I showed you many tools, but still those were not all. I'm going to take you to Office 365 interface and show you what our Office 365 has to offer, because that is the way you're going to get connected. This is a platform which will keep you connected, and I call it my suitcase when I'm traveling the World Wide Web. This is what our Office 365 interface looks like. These are few apps that are available over here. We are very, very high on using OneNote and Teams. Forms is something that we use for quiz. We no more print worksheets for schools who swear to go paperless. Forms is something that will help you in a big way. For those who are looking for another way to present, Sway is another tool with which you can work. And in all these tools, you can work in a collaborative manner with your students. Let me take you to Sway and show you what a simple app it is. It's a simple presentation tool which even our grade 2 students use for making presentations. It's a highly intuitive app where if you need to create a new Sway, all you need to do is type the word. So let's say I give my students a topic, they can definitely create a Sway all by themselves, because this intuitive platform picks up what I type. Let's say I type OneNote, or I type, no, let me go more student. Let's say I want to know all about animals. So I simply have to type all about animals and it'll give me options to explore. So this is what Sway interface looks like when you open it. And yes, you can definitely have a Sway in Hindi. We've created those. I'm happy to share. So languages do work here. So when I open up a Microsoft Sway, a new Sway, I just have to title it. Let's say I write animals. And I say background image. If you notice, this is highly intuitive and it'll give me a bunch of pictures that I can browse through. Let's say I click through this. I get pictures of animals and I simply have to pick and draw. This is a touch screen that I'm using, but right now what I have used is just a pick and drop, but I can simply choose to click here and drag it here. It's as simple as that. Let's say I want to choose another image and I caption over here mammals. Again, when I click here, this is very intuitive. It'll automatically pick up my word and suggest me images here. So you see my dropdown already has mammals available to me. I simply have to choose and drag and drop here. That's it. And my presentation will look something like this. Sway is a new tool. OneNote is also a new tool. This is what my presentation will look like. I can modify it right from here, or I can go ahead and modify for more options going back to the way I was doing. More on this when we are there for you with you, and we are happy to do that presentation for you. Therefore, please just help us connect with you, reach out, and we'll be happy to get back more ways of doing this for you. Thank you so very much for joining us today. I'm still around for answering more questions, but if you have to go, I completely understand that you have to go. Thank you so much for joining in. We have more dates for these webinars. To come back, please excite others to join. Let them begin and carry on and start their journey with us. Thank you so very much. Duita, do we have more questions? All right. Great. So thank you so very much for joining in. Please stay tuned in. Please stay connected. You have many ways of staying connected. We will be forming WhatsApp groups now with these people so that we can carry forward. You may feel free to leave that WhatsApp group. The link to WhatsApp group also is being shared. I'm so sorry that echoed. Ragini, may I please request you to mute yourself? Rather, I'm going to mute myself because I think Ragini has something to say. The WhatsApp link has been shared multiple times in the group. Please feel free to join the group. I'm going to mute yourself. Ragini, please unmute yourself and speak to us. Okay, I'm still around. If there are any questions, any comments, kindly leave them here. We'll be happy to answer. Thank you so very much for your time. We are very, very thankful to you for joining us today. Have a really good evening and keep learning, keep sharing, and keep coming back to us if you have any problems. A screenshot away is what we are. A phone call away is what we are. An email away is what we are. Thank you so much. Have a lovely evening. Thank you for joining. Thank you.